For a robot. What these LEDs are designed to do is that when we finally have a robot fully created, we will apply these to certain sections so that our driver can have visual inputs as to certain things that are happening within the robot, whether or not there are balls in the hopper, or if our vision's lined up, or depending on how we have our driving oriented.
We're currently working on trying to integrate the code from the Arduino board into the code from the rest of the robot.
Right now I'm working on the bumpers for the chassis, and we're cutting some of the metal pieces.
I worked with Jen on the bumpers today, and yesterday too. So right now I'm like drilling holes for the L bars that go in the bumpers.
Right now we're working on getting a second controls board made. We found out that we'll have to have two done. We already have one, but we need a second one. And also we're mounting cameras on both chassis.
So this is for the inner frame of the robot. It'll like help support the like everything above the bottom layer of the chassis.
Right now we're cutting out a new reinforced plate chip liner and some intake parts.
We're cutting out a lot of gussets today for the framing,
a lot of gussets,
space, and everything.
We tested our prototype today, and it worked pretty well. I mean, make your business like even thicker metal, and then we're gonna cut those parts out and probably retest. Make sure you change the height.
We're working on attaching our poly card to our intake. We ran into an issue where it was too much tension on it, and we couldn't get the hex shaft through, so we adjusted our length, and right now it's working. We're checking the compression on the ball with the intake to see if it's gonna actually work. Well, for coding the Arduino stuff, I had no idea about anything really for Arduino coming into it. It was kind of difficult at first, figuring out what exactly to do, but with the help of one of our mentors, I was able to create some pretty highly functioning code that'll be very useful to us, I believe, in the field.
We had some problem with the chain that I fixed, and we're having some difficulties with the climber, but I have some other people fixing it.
The challenges that I had was we had to cut this L bar over here, so it was 0.75 inches from that end. And we didn't, the first advance really didn't assist us in that, so I asked Mr. Kowalski and like the team leaders, they suggested that I use the Blade Runner, so I used that. That was like one of the challenges that I had.
I think we've gone through a lot of prints of the mounting the camera, but I think we got it figured out now.
Set it down, right, James? Okay, just sort of set it down. You know, this is where we set it down all the time. But because of how many times we've used it in like throughout the years, this started coming off, which I think it's already coming off right now. And this flew out. I turned this off before, it pretty much just like killed us all, but.
So now we have a button on the joystick where if you hold it, our robot will like move left and right until it's exactly centered on the center of the vision tape for the boiler target.
So how long have you been working on it?
So since the start of build season, so around 3 weeks now.
Do you feel like it's reliable right now?
Yeah, it's definitely reliable. We're able to get it centered. It's oscillating a little bit, but it's working good. I've been working a lot with Mr. Brown, Mr. Bala, and Mason.
Have there been any challenges along the way?
Trying to do the math to get the distance from center has been like, that took 2 weeks almost. So it's going to be, the shooting's going to be completely autonomous. We don't have to rely on the driver, and we're going to use it during autonomous mode to place gears too. We try to get distance more accurate. We can try to stop it from oscillating so much and just tune the PID.
Hopefully we can start wiring all the chassis. We don't have the frames from mechanical yet, but once we get those, we'll work on wiring them all up and getting everything working.
Hopefully we'll be done with this in not too long. We're just trying to troubleshoot through a few things right now, just so, because the code for the Arduino LEDs are done, and it should be working with the Rio right now, but we're just troubleshooting it and trying to figure out why it isn't working right now.